Good evening. Welcome to the Freaky Tiki Theater, your last stop for cinematic slop. And even though it's Christmas, we're still going to subject you to some cinematic slop. Don't you worry. We're not sure what it is. Dickie, do we know what we're showing tonight?
It's going to be a Christmas surprise potpourri. We got a few classic 60s TV Christmas specials. Those are great.
Yeah.
And a few clips from a lot of famous Christmas musicals. It should be a lot of fun.
It'll be Christmas.
Hey, we've been drinking eggnog up here since 2 o'clock this afternoon, so you have to bear with us.
Kevin Mayo up in the control room tonight, too. Kevin, you've been hitting that eggnog, too?
Oh, yeah. It's great.
Well, this ought to be an interesting show. We'll make it even more interesting right now by introducing my co-host, Teddy Jaguar.
Yeah. Hey, how y'all doing tonight?
Teddy Jaguar.
This is a good night. Sit back, drink some eggnog.
That's right.
And put whatever, some rum in and enjoy our show.
Whatever adult beverage you enjoy.
Looking sharp, Mr. J.
Yes, we've got our station jackets on that they gave us back in 63. I got mine when I started. Mine's a little tight. They gave Teddy his when he started, but he went through that radioactive mist on a boat. And you know what happens there.
I know. Wow.
Speaking of radioactive, let's introduce Taylor Made, the Freaky Tiki Goddess.
Yay! Hey, guys.
Taylor.
How is
How are you tonight? Woo! Oh. Is that a whoopee cushion?
Somebody magically laid that on my
She's a prankster.
Yeah.
Wow. I was thinking about it, but then I might ruin the show also, so let's not go there.
Yeah. Not even there.
Better than ruining your pants, of course, but yes.
Would have been a great joke, though.
Yeah, it'd been a good joke.
It would have been a... dog and put a little rum in it.
Ooh, man, we already know the result of that.
So you guys ready for Christmas?
Yeah, everybody got your shopping done?
I'm still working on it.
Yeah, me too. I can't.
Yeah, you know, what the heck. Actually, I'm sending out cards that saying a donation has been made in your name to the TB Foundation.
WTFTB.
Yes. Yes.
Wow.
But like we said, though, we're not really, you know, we don't have a set movie tonight because the public domain Christmas movies that's in the WTFTV 93 library, I mean, they're lame, you know?
Why not show something
Santa
good?
Claus versus the Martians. That one foreign thing, the Santa Claus or whatever. We're not going to show that. So we're going to show you some bits. We're going to have some Christmas fun.
Right.
And we're just going to enjoy ourselves with adult beverages and, you know, the usual routine. So we'll
Also, we're getting a song out of you guys tonight.
That's true, yeah.
You guys are doing the number.
We'll give you some different entertainment, you know.
And your yearly reading of the Night Before Christmas.
Yes, the WTF-TV tradition. I read the Night Before Christmas story to all the staff and their young ones, so that'll be a moving experience.
Gather the kids.
Yes.
Right.
But first off, we'll move
nice
in.
Night.
Yeah, we'll move into our first Christmas
sleep
thing,
tight.
Whatever it
don't
is.
Sleep yet.
So we'll be back in a second.
Michael, it's Susan. Are you going to be home tonight? Well, I'd like to leave a little something under your tree. Round 8? See you then.
A few years ago, I wouldn't have dreamed of inviting myself over to Michael's place. People would have said it wasn't respectful, but times have changed. And when you're giving him Harvey's Crystal Cream, it's more than respectable. It's downright upright.
Harvey's Crystal Cream for the holidays.
Oh, cartons of Camels are sure to please. Besides, they look so handsome under Christmas trees. So easy to give, so good to get. Give Camels, the nation's favorite cigarette. Ho, ho, ho. It's gift-packed, ready to give, with a space for your greeting.
You know Dasher and Dancer and Prancer and Vixen, Comet and Cupid and Donner and Blitzen.
But do you recall the most famous reindeer of all? Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer had a very shiny nose. And if you ever saw it, you would even say it glows. All of the other reindeer used to laugh and call him names. They never let poor Rudolph join in any reindeer games. Then
one foggy Christmas Eve, Santa came to say,
Rudolph, with your nose so bright,
won't you guide my sleigh tonight? Then how the reindeer loved him as they shouted out with glee, Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer, you'll go down in history.
'Twas the day before Christmas, and all through the hills the reindeer were playing, enjoying the spills of skating and coasting and climbing the willows and hopscotch and leapfrog, protected by pillows.
Look, fellas, it's Rudolph. His nose is a sight. It's red as a beet.
Twice as big and twice as bright. Looky, looky, I'm Rudolph.
Poor Rudolph. Where most reindeer's noses are brownish and tiny, Rudolph's was red, very large and quite shiny.
Rudolph! Go on home, red nose. Your mama's calling you.
Come, come, Rudolph. Tonight you hang up your stocking.
His nose is a sight. It's red as a beet.
Twice as big and twice as bright.
While way, way up north on this dark, foggy night, awaiting the time for his Christmas Eve flight, good old Santa.
This fog will be hard to get through. Quick, get hitched in a hurry. Dasher, Dancer, Prancer, Vixen, Comet, Cupid, Donner, Blitzen. Hi-ho! To keep our direction, we'll have to fly low. Come down here, quick! Hi-ho! Pretty close. Hi-ho!
The air was still foggy, the night dark and drear when Santa arrived at the home of the deer. But all this took time and filled Santa with gloom, while slowly he groped toward the next reindeer's room. The lamp wasn't burning. The glow came instead from Rudolph's red nose at the head of the bed. And then came the greatest idea in all history. So Rudolph is told of the dark and delay, the fog and the blackness and losing the way.
I need you tonight. to lead all my dear on the rest of our flight.
Dear Mommy and Daddy, I have gone to help Santa. Don't worry. Rudolph, that's me.
Hurry, Rudolph. It's very dark here.
With Rudolph's red nose as a wonderful light, old Santa flew quickly the rest of the night. So fast that before it was day, the very last present was given away.
Hear ye, a message from Rudolph.
Yes, they'd found Rudolph's message. It's all over town.
Hear ye, Rudolph at the stadium. Come on, come on.
Bad deer who used to do nothing but tease him? Well, now they'd do anything only to please him.
Rudolph, my boy, they'll envy you now, far and near, for no greater honor can come to a deer than riding with Santa and guiding my sleigh. The number one job on the number one day. I hope you'll continue to keep us from grief. I hereby appoint you Commander-in-Chief.
And Rudolph just blushed from his head to his toes until his whole fur was as red as his nose.
Merry Christmas to all, and to all a good night.
Then all the reindeer loved him, as they shouted out with glee. Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer, you'll go down in history.
Hey, so what'd you think of that first Christmas thing? Did you like it?
It was nice.
Yeah, drop us an email and tell us what it was.
Right, check it out.
We're busy drinking and stuff. We're properly juiced now. We're all going to get together here. We're going to do our the traditional WTF TV Christmas kind of carol song. But, you know, we're going to take something a little less hokey. And, you know, we're going to let you guys experience something a little different from the Freaky Tiki crew here. So, Dickie, you want to go ahead and roll that playback?
Okay, here it comes. Remember, I'll do my killer Rosemary Clooney.
That's right, Rosemary Clooney's the best. I think George Clooney mistakes you for his mom.
Snow, it won't be long before we'll all be there with snow.
Snow, I want to wash my hands, my face and hair with snow.
Snow, I long to clear a path and lift a spade of snow.
Snow, to see a great big man entirely made of snow.
Oh, where it's snowing all winter through, that's where I want to be.
Snowball throwing, that's what I'll do. How I'm longing to ski through the snow.
Those glistening houses that seem to be built of snow.
Snow, to see a mountain covered with a quilt of snow. What is Christmas with no snow?
No white Christmas with no,
no
snow.
Snow.
Snow, I'll soon be there with snow. I wash my hair with snow.
And with a spade of snow, I'll build a man that's made of snow. I'd love to stay up with you, but I recommend a little shut-eye, go to sleep and dream of snow.
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 Oh, that was fabulous, I'm here to tell you. What a great number. Oh.
Action. Okay, cut. That's fine, fellas. Thanks, Duke. See you in the morning.
Good night, Mr. Wellman. Folks, there's a little rough and tumble for you. But even in motion pictures, if you were to have a man fighting for his life every 5 minutes or so, it'd seem a little bloodthirsty. Well, in real life, every 5 minutes, one American is attacked by tuberculosis, TB. Murph, you got those Christmas seals?
Coming up, Mr. Wayne.
TB attacks at any age, old folks right on down the line to the kids, like these on this year's Christmas seals. Maybe you have a couple of youngsters like these, a little older, a little younger. The point is that Christmas seals fight tuberculosis, and when you buy and use Christmas seals, you're helping to prevent TB from getting at them, or at any of us. You never know whose life you're saving when you buy Christmas seals, but the important thing is that you are helping to save lives. So please answer your Christmas seal letter today. And if it hasn't arrived, mail your contribution to your Tuberculosis Association. Ask them to send you your Christmas seals. Thank you very much.
Welcome to the Perry Como Christmas Show, starring Peggy Fleming. Special attraction, Rich Little and his friend. Special guest stars, the Carpenters.
It's that time of year when the world falls in love. Every song you hear seems to say, Merry Christmas, may your every wish come true. It could happen to you.
Cover their jugs all up with the feathers, you know, Reg. They ought to cut the costumes up a little higher on the thigh there so you can see more ass.
You make me sick when you speak, Morris.
This isn't art, it's a sex.
Put your butt in gear for the love of God!
So, did you enjoy that last Christmas bit, or whatever we're showing, Christmassy, you know?
Classic.
Yeah.
It was really cool, man, really cool.
It was. See, you know, what we're having here right after the show tonight, cool. WTF TV 93 is having its annual Christmas party, so most of the staff and engineering is already down there getting warmed up. We're just going to finish up the show here. We're going to have our usual food, open food, everybody brings in a dish, also a gift exchange this year. Which we always have every year.
And speaking of gifts and presents, Tony, your gift is up here from the station manager's wife. It's here. It's a pretty big box this year.
This freaking thing is warped. Wait, what?
Again?
Wait. You got to do it. You never, ever let us see it. We got to see it this year. Come on. This is the year.
Well, I'll go up in the office and get it. And
then, be a good sport.
Yeah, we'll go to a couple of little funny thing, comedy bit stuff here, then we'll be back.
Yeah.
Hey, this Christmas party is getting a little too quiet. I think it's time we liven it up with my favorite Christmas gift, Mr. Microphone.
Hey, what's that?
Well, you set the dial on your FM radio and testing.
These kids are having a fabulous time with Mr. Microphone, the cordless microphone that actually puts your voice on the radio. There are no attaching wires, so you're free to move around. Broadcast over any FM car radio.
Hey, good looking. We'll be back to pick you up later.
Professional entertainers use Mr. Microphone for rehearsing.
I got one.
It's practical and great fun for the whole family. Only $17.88. Mr. Microphone, buy two or three, they really make great Christmas gifts.
At Walco, Walgreens, Gamble's, Osco, Pamita, Promart, Davis, OK, and City Markets.
Wonderful new idea for Christmas fun. Now you can turn your home into a window wonderland with the magic of glass wax and a set of these easy to use cutout stencils for glass wax. Why, it's so easy a child can do it. Just pour regular glass wax into a dish, dip in a sponge, and simply dab over one of the stencil designs. Put a jolly Santa like this on your windows in a matter of seconds. Or Christmas trees, wreaths, Santa and his reindeer. All the lovely signs of Christmas that will make your home a window wonderland. All through the magic of glass wax and a set of these cutout stencils for glass wax. Buy your set of Christmas stencils wherever you buy regular glass wax. Beautiful holiday designs to help make a window wonderland at your home this Christmas.
Have you ever wondered how the man who drives a snowplow drives to the snowplow? This one drives a Volkswagen. So you can stop wondering.
I want to see it.
Oh, boy, I didn't stop.
Oh, my gosh, I love it.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, yuck it up, laughing
it's
boy.
It's a
yeah.
Oh, thank you, guys. It's so cute.
Yeah.
Wow. You got to wear that out.
You sure? Wow. Yeah, well, we can go out tonight after the show if you want.
Yeah.
You want to wear that thing, Tony?
He's adorable, guys.
You look like a pink nightmare in that.
Aww. You guys, I think it's cute.
Tell the guy to take it off. Come on, David.
I think it's cute, though.
It's cool. It's
cool. All right, Tony. All right.
You got him rolling up here,
yeah,
Tony.
Yeah, take it off.
Save that.
You seen it. You satisfied?
Yeah, I am.
For some reason, Woo! She gets me confused with Teddy every year, and this is the stuff I get. Well, back to whatever.
Oh, that looks good. I like it.
Well, let's get back to the show.
Once a year when Christmas comes, I pack my sled with dolls and drums, and I'm on my way with happiness for little girls and boys. Oh, there isn't any place too far. I go wherever children are, always on my way with happiness, wrapped up in fancy toys. My Christmas list, I've names and places.
Though we've never seen their faces, we know each one and the good they've done.
Over hill and dale again this year, I brought glad tidings and a good cheer. So until another Christmas day, when I pay another call, I'll say Merry Christmas.
Hey kids, I bet you
Now I bet you. Sorry for Santa.
Yeah, man, he's sure tired and worn.
Ach, yeah.
His house looks so wacky, hacky, hola.
Him claws, very, very bloody and torn.
Da.
See, he help everyone at Christmas, but no one they think of Santa Claus.
Well, we could do something for Santa if we only just tidied his house.
Spot will pass my eye.
I'll shine his shoes with a boogie beat, and here's the reason why. Oh, we know we owe much to Santa for making every Christmas day. We want to do something for Santa
and end our little day. Thank him for the happiness that came our way.
Present for me?
Hey,
Well, I hope you enjoyed that last Christmas bit, whatever it was. I hope it was cheery and Yuletide-y like, you know. Yeah, anything's better than that last break I had to endure.
It was cute.
Oh, cute. I don't know. You know.
It was pink.
Yeah, it was pink.
It was not.
I will never live that down if anybody at the track sees that.
That's unbelievable.
I'll never get another marker. But anyways, we're going to get a little more sophisticated here. I'm going to do the traditional WTF TV 93 reading of A Night Before Christmas. Freaky, steaky, tiki style, yes.
All right.
So what we'll do, we'll get to that right now.
Get the kids. Anybody at home watching, get the kids around.
That's right. Gather the kids around.
Grab the eggnog.
It's a whole family thing here.
Yes, it is. Yeah, all righty. What we'll do here.
Wonder what this story's about.
Well, you're about to find out. Now, this book is old. It's like on parchment or some kind of crusty type stuff. So anyways, we'll get started right now. 'Twas the night before Christmas, and Santa says to Teddy, "Fire up the sleigh. We're almost ready."
Yeah.
But this ain't no ordinary sleigh. This one's from Chevrolet.
Ooh,
and Santa and Teddy looked on with glee, because this Impala was built in 1963.
That's a good year.
The year I started here.
Leave you hanging. Let's go.
Teddy says, "Damn, Santa, that sure sounds good. That's because there's 409 cubes under the hood."
What?
And with that, they took off down the hill. First stop, Monsterville.
Wow.
Wow. Go, Teddy.
And with little or no hassle, they pulled up to the big old castle. "Damn, Santa, you blind? This castle's Frankenstein's."
Damn, love it.
Castle Frankenstein, yeah. That's a Christmassy feel. And Santa says, "Come on, Teddy, there's nothing to fear. Take the presents up, I'll wait here."
All right.
Smart move on Santa's part.
Yeah, not too much testosterone going there in Santa. So anyways, Teddy makes the climb up to the door and meets Big Frankie. All 7'4".
Wow.
That's a big guy.
Big guy.
Big.
Uh-huh.
Really big.
Teddy takes off in a flash. "Come on, Santa. He's right on my ass."
Wow.
So Santa lets it rip. And you could hear it all the way to the Monsterville drag strip.
I love it.
Got some of them Thrush Turbosonics on there. So the next stop was the house of TaylorMade.
Uh-oh, here we go.
Teddy says, "I hope we're leaving something cool." "Hell yeah," said Santa. "It's a 10-foot solid gold stripper pole." And because she'd been such a naughty girl, Santa couldn't wait to see her give it a whirl.
Whoa. I'm with Santa on that one.
Yeah, I hope Santa brought some dollars.
Right.
So anyways, the next stop, the house of Dickie Ho.
All right.
He got an AFX slot car track set, the scale HO.
Wow.
I hope I get the Nomad 55 yet.
Oh, of course. And then on to Kevin Mayo's. Only one thing on his list, each and every Aurora model kit.
Oh, yeah, the monsters, the classic monsters. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
So Teddy and Santa, word off. Well, looks like I've spilled some bourbon down here, but it says Teddy and
roared off, I think is what.
Yes, roared off. Roared off into the moonlight and soon called it a night.
Hey.
All right, it's an adventure.
And when Teddy got home and looked under his tree, to find a case of Veenie Weenies. A present from his pal, Tony Martini.
All right, that's a fine present right there.
So good night to all and all a good night. Merry Christmas, everybody.
Have a good night.
Woo! Because so many Americans think getting drunk is fun, we thought you might like to join us in a national drinking game. Just answer yes or no to the following 10 questions. Do you talk a lot about drinking?
Only when I'm awake.
Do you drink more than you used to?
I try to.
Do you gulp your drinks?
Only out of a glass.
Do you often take a drink to feel better? Do you drink alone?
Only if I'm stuck.
Do you ever forget what you did while you were drinking? Do you keep a bottle hidden somewhere for quick pick-me-ups?
How does he know?
Do you sometimes start drinking without really thinking about it?
Sometimes.
Do you need a drink to have fun?
I do now.
Do you ever take a drink in the morning to relieve a hangover?
Uh-huh.
Congratulations. If you had four or more yes answers, then you may be one of over 9 million Americans with a drinking problem.
Hi. Welcome back. You know, I think, for my money, the old standards were actually the best when it comes to music. That, gosh, I wonder who that could be. Come on in. Hi.
Merry Christmas.
Well.
I live just down the road.
Sure, nice to see you, Ted. How are you? I've seen you in town.
You look familiar. Do I know you?
Well, I'm Dave Letterman.
Oh, yeah, nice my parents used to watch you when they were kids.
Yeah. Well, what can I do for you, Ted?
Well, you know, I'm a singer too, Dave.
Right.
Do you like the old Christmas carols,
Oh, gee, I think some of the old stuff. I think some of the new stuff. I think it's all really very marvelous.
Well, maybe, I don't know. I mean, maybe you and I could sing one together, you know, kind of like old meets new.
Well, I don't know.
Well, see, I'll tell you, I don't know either, but this is a nice one. Let's give that one a whack.
Oh, okay, what the heck. But, you know, I can't promise anything. I'm kind of rusty. But here it goes. All right, we'll give this a try, all right? Okay. Ready?
Yeah.
All right. Thanks for dropping by, Ted. Here we go.
Chestnuts roasting on an open fire, Jack Frost nipping at your nose, Yuletide carols being sung by a choir, and folks dressed up like Eskimos. Take it easy.
Everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe help to make the season bright. Tiny tots with their eyes all aglow will find it hard to sleep tonight.
Notice Santa is on his way.
He's loaded lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh.
And every mother's child is gonna spy to see if reindeer can really fly.
And so I'm offering this simple phrase
to kids from 1 to 92.
Although it's been said many times, many ways,
Christmas,
Merry Christmas,
Merry Christmas
to you.
You know, man, you still got it.
Thank you very much, Ted. Have a happy holiday, Ted.
Sure.
All right, we have to do another commercial, and then we'll be right back, folks. Thanks, Ted. Nice job. Right.
Wonderful Christmas gift for anyone who smokes, because it says Merry Christmas and Happy Smoking 200 times. Yes, 10 packs of those better tasting Luckies, all done up for Christmas in a beautiful carton created just for Lucky Strike by the famous designer, Mr. Raymond Loy. It'll look so bright and colorful under your Christmas tree, and it's such a welcome gift to anyone who enjoys a good smoke. Because, you know, smoking enjoyment is all a matter of taste. And the fact of the matter is, Lucky's taste better. Cleaner, fresher, smoother. That's why you can't go wrong if you remember your friends with these colorful Christmas cartons of Lucky Strike.
Be happy, go lucky, for Christmas gifts this year.
Well, that wraps it up for the Freaky Tiki Theater Christmas episode.
That's a pretty good one.
Yeah,
it's a great one.
As much fun as we did. Yeah.
Hey,
hope you enjoyed
fun.
All of them Christmassy shows.
Hey, who you calling?
Yeah. Yeah, he's ordering a Christmas pizza. That's probably what he's doing. Extra cranberry on there.
The Judy Garland is classic.
Yeah, that Judy Garland bit. Holy fuck. Holy. It was, man. She had more pills in her than a CVS pharmacy. Wow. But anyways, we don't want to, you know, taint your Christmas spirit with a doped up Judy Garland.
He said he wants some eggnog with rum in it.
Well, that's good. Everybody wants eggnog
tell
with rum.
We'll be there shortly.
Yeah, we'll get it to you. But anyways, we want to tell you we enjoyed spending Christmas with you. And keep them cards and letters coming in because we really enjoy reading
always.
Those. You know, sending in pictures and stuff. So there's some really talented people out there in our viewing audience. So, but anyways, you know, we enjoy it. And all of us here at Freaky Tiki want to wish you a Merry Christmas.
And have a good Christmas. Enjoy the night.
Yes.
Aloha. Merry Christmas, guys.
Merry Christmas, everybody.
Merry Christmas.
Aloha.
Aloha.
Get him off the stand.